नमस्ते एंड गुड मॉर्निंग।
नमस्ते, गुड मॉर्निंग।
हाउ आर यू?
आई एम गुड। आई हैव गॉट अ क्वेश्चन बिफोर वी स्टार्ट। आई मिस्ड द क्लास यस्टरडे बट आई कैन नॉट फाइंड इट ऑन यूट्यूब।
हाँ, दिस क्वेश्चन इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू आंसर फॉर मी। आई एम ऑनेस्ट एंड दिस आंसर विल बी गिवन बाय द मैनेजमेंट टीम फ्रॉम द हिमालयन योगा एसोसिएशन। Because even I haven't watched my own video.
Because you know, every other class we do, it's on YouTube, but anatomy is not there. So I've already posted a question for the management because I don't want to leave it for too long. You know, I want to have everything in one place. So.
Okay.
And they haven't replied. You know. The management hasn't replied why the videos are not there.
Okay, no problem. Or I will just tell them to answer you.
Please.
Or reply the students back soon. I will tell them.
So could you just quickly before we start cover what you covered yesterday? What were you talking about yesterday?
Yes. And before we start the session, we would like to chant opening prayer and one mantra first. ॐ असतो मां सद्गमय, तमसो मां ज्योतिर्गमय, मृत्योर्मां अमृतं गमय। We will chant an Om one time and then we will chant Shanti three times. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Thank you so much. We have Rekha ji today. Namaste, Rekha.
Hello.
Namaskaram. Are you also for the 300 hours?
No, for 200 hours.
So, okay, let me tell you, people, this session in the afternoon is for the 300 hours class, and the session which is in the morning at 8:30 a.m. according to Indian time is for the 200 hours. I mean that syllabus is for the 200 hours. This syllabus is for 300 hours, just so that you know.
Oh, so I don't need to be in this session?
I am not saying like this. That depends. You can discuss with the management later or the thing. So whatever course you have been doing, try to learn the things according to the course. Or you can ask, but if you are here now, you can still be and learn.
Okay.
If you wish to join for today.
So which class
just want
is
to
this
tell
one?
You, this is for the 300 hours every day in the afternoon from 12:45 to 1:30 according to Indian time.
Okay, okay.
And morning time for 200 hours.
Yeah. So okay. I didn't know because other teachers said like, you know, other teacher will be there, so I thought like in there may be another one, so I'm just joining the first class, so I didn't know.
Okay, so this is your first class.
I mean like today is my first day. I didn't join before.
Okay, so today is your first day of your course.
Yeah. I missed some days, yeah.
Okay, no problem.
So I didn't know. That's fine, you can stay. If it's not in the syllabus, then I will leave.
It is there in the syllabus, but it is a bit advanced. I mean,
okay, I will, so, anyway, because I was here, then I will just listen to you.
Okay, no problem. But tomorrow 8:30 a.m. for 200 hours, you can also join us. So that is what will be helpful for you if you are doing the 200 hours course. So what we studied yesterday or what we have revised yesterday, Maringa, and for those who have, we have discussed about the axial skeletal system even yesterday. So we have talked about the bones which are present in the one axis of our body, that means the bones in our head, neck, and we have discussed some things about the back and our spine. So the number of bones in our vertebral column are 26, where we discussed about the spine, where the upper region of our spine is the cervical region, where you have 7 bones. Then you will have 12 bones in the middle section of your spine, the thoracic region. That thing should be in this recorded video. Maybe the management will give you this video soon, hopefully. And then we have discussed about the lumbar section, that is the lower back of the spine, right on the whiteboard. But in yesterday's session, which you have missed, apart from that, we have also seen the ribs and the sternum. So sternum is our chest bone in our center over here. And to the sternum, there are 24 ribs. So we have 12 ribs on each side. 12 ribs on right side, 12 ribs on left side, because all these ribs are connected to the thoracic region of our vertebral column on the spine. And the last 4 ribs, that means 2 on the right side and 2 on the left side, are floating in the front, but not on the back. All the ribs, the 12 ribs on each side, are connected to the 12 thoracic vertebrae of our vertebral column on our back and spine. So this is what I am telling you in short. This we have seen in depth in the yesterday's session. Okay. And yesterday we have completed the axial skeletal system, that means the bones in our head, in our skull cranium, in our facial skeletal, in our ears, in our neck, in our spine, and in our sternum and ribs. So total we have completed 8080 bones, 8080 number of bones. So today we will start with the appendicular skeletal system. Appendicular skeletal system is what? The bones which are not in the axial skeletal, that means in our upper limbs and in our lower limbs. So the bones which are present in our upper limbs and lower limbs are appendicular skeletal. Namaste Akhilesh ji. Here I can see as a new student here. I would like to ask Akhilesh Kumarji, for you as well. Are you also for a 200 hours course or 300 hours course?
Hello, G. Yes. Can't you hear me? Namaste.
Yes, I.
I have registered for a 300 hours course.
Okay, great. Correct.
Acha. Yeto, is it the correct course?
Yes. Okay. Yes.
And now, no?
Yes, yes. So you are on the right lecture, I mean, on the right section. So you are with the syllabus here. And Rekha ji is a new student. Let her join and also. So Akhilesh ji, you are on the right. So every day you have to be here for the anatomy session at 12:45. According to
otherwise I will attend the pre-recorded because I'm from Greece.
Okay.
And due to the work issues,
yes, yes,
I cannot attend it properly easily.
Yes, there's no problem. So you can see the pre-recorded sessions if they are available on the YouTube. Okay.
Shubh naam kya hai, sir?
Mera naam Ashubham. I am Shubham.
Ashubham ji, acha. Okay, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Namaste.
now we will proceed further with the appendix or skeletal system. We will start today. First, in the appendicular skeletal system, the first one, you know, is pectoral girdle, which we have also seen yesterday. We also seen what is pectoral girdle yesterday. Pectoral girdle means what? The bones which connect our arm to one axis. So what are those bones which connect our arm to our axis? Those bones are our collarbone and our shoulder blade. So these bones, the collarbone known as clavicle and the shoulder blade that is known as scapula. So the clavicle and the scapula is what? Our pectoral girdle. I will draw the pectoral girdle here today with the red marker. So if this is a collarbone, here it connects with our shoulder blade. And this is what? Our pectoral girdle. This is our axis. This side is our body. Now, the next, only these two bones are pectoral girdle. Got it here, Meringa?
Yeah, yeah.
And the rest, yeah. Then the rest is what? The bones of our arm. So here, we have the arm. I'm drawing our arm in with the black marker. So you will see here, the first bone. There is only one bone in our upper arm. One bone in our upper arm. That bone is known as humerus. What is the name of that bone? Humerus. What were the names of the pectoral girdle? This one was clavicle. And this one was scapula, shoulder blade. Okay, the bones of our arms, next, the B section. This was A, pectoral girdle, is the longest bone in our arm, humerus. Now, below, in our forearm, how many bones will be present in each forearm? Two. What are these two bones in our forearm known as? Radius and ulna. So, we'll make my camera below here. Yep. This is what the radius and ulna. So, if this is the midline of our body, this section here is the midline of the body. So, the bone towards the thumb side, if we place our arm like this, straight, the bone towards the thumb side here is what? The radius. This bone is the radius, and the bone at the lateral side is what? Ulna. So this bone here, I will make it as radius. And this bone, I will make it as ulna. The shaded bone is the radius. This shaded bone is the strongest bone in our forearm. So in our whole arm, actually, the strongest bone in our arm only is the radius bone, where the weight of our body we carry on our radius bone while practicing some of the postures like Chaturanga Dandasana, the plank pose, the crow pose, the crane pose, the handstand. So all the postures or arm balancing poses, we do shift the weight of our body on the radius bone, or the radius bone is helping to carry the weight of the body during the arm balancing postures in the practice of yoga. Okay, up till here is this clear? Ulna is just at the side, lateral side. This is ulna bone. This one is the radius bone towards the thumbs. Okay. Next, we have the bones in our wrist. These bones in our wrist are known as carpals. So the bones in our wrist are known as carpals. First of all, there are 8 types of carpals. How many? 8 kinds of carpals in our wrist. So these carpals bone in our wrist are irregular shape of bones. Are the irregular shape of the bones. For example, in our carpals, there are different names of the carpals. We have capitate, we have trapezoid, we have trapezium, we have lunate, we have triquetrium, like pisiform and hammate. So these are all the different kinds and the names of the bones in our wrist. But these sets of bones, just write one word that is important to know, the wrist, all these wrist bones, lunate, scaphoid, trapezium, triquetrium, all these 8 types of bones are known as carpals. That means the bones in your wrist. Here you will see the bones, all these 8 small tiny bones are in your wrist. There are 8 bones in one wrist. So how many will be there in both the wrists? 16. There are 16 carpals in your arms. So to these carpals, you will have metacarpals. So now I will name these as carpals, wrist bones. And now we will see what are the metacarpals. Metacarpals are those bones which are connected to your fingers. So which connects your wrist to your fingers. Let me ask you the simple question. How many metacarpals will be there in one hand?
5.
Yes, because we have 5 fingers. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So these are your metacarpals, not the wrist I am counting, to each and every finger. So there are these bones. These are 5 metacarpals, the red one. And to these metacarpals, there will be the finger bones. The bones in your fingers are known as phalanges. The bones in your fingers are known as phalanges. And where are these phalanges? So there are how many phalanges in each finger? How many phalanges you can see in your each finger? Can you see your hand, different surface of your palm? Right over here. If you will see 1, 2
on each,
3
on each
finger, 3 phalanges. So these are 3 different sections. So this is 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, like 3 phalanges in each finger. But how many phalanges in your thumb? Only 2. So this is the section 1 and 2. So total
14.
there will be 14 phalanges. That means the bones in your fingers. Okay, 3 on each finger, 2 on the thumb. How many bones you will see here now? In our arm, how many, the longest bone in the upper arm, how many numerals? 2. We are counting on the both sides, considering both the arms, okay? So 2 humerus bone, radius 2, ulna 2. Then carpals 8 on each wrist. Then we have metacarpals 10, 5 on each hand, and phalanges 28. That means 14 on each finger. How many bones now can you calculate? 2 humerus, 2 ulna, 2 radius, 6. Plus 16 carpals, that is 22. Plus we have 10 metacarpals, that is
32.
And plus 28 phalanges. 32 plus 28, who is good in math?
60,
great. So we have 60 number of bones in our arm, both the arms including. And how many pectoral girdle? The number of, so 2 clavicle and 2 scapula. So pectoral girdle we have 4. And bones in the arms we have 60. Pectoral girdle is not the part of the bones of the arm. This is what? Which connects our arm to the axial skeleton. So we have drawn this in the red color and arm in the black color. Got it? Can I erase this?
Yeah.
Now, pectoral girdle, bones of the arm. Now what we will see? Pelvic girdle and bones of our legs. So number 3. Number 1 was pectoral. Number 2 was bones of the arm. Number 3 is pelvic girdle. This pelvic girdle is what? Which connects our legs to the axial skeleton of the body. So here again we'll choose the red color to make sure the pelvic is different from our leg. Here I will draw it more above. Just a quick. Just to know the concept, we are drawing here the pelvic, not approximate here. Now, above the pelvic is our spine, always remember. So here is our spine, the vertebra above, the lumbar region. Then it starts with the sacrum. Sacrum region is what? Of our spine, which is inserted in the pelvic. So this is what? The sacrum region inserted, this blue section is all about the spine. This is your vertebra of the spine, and this is your tailbone. This is what? Your tailbone inside your pelvic. That is known as coccyx, which you will know when you will see the video yesterday section. So this is blue section, is all about the spine. So don't, oh my God. Let me know if you cannot see the whiteboard sometimes due to the angle of the camera. Here in our pelvic, we have these two bones known as hip bones. So one and two are the only two important bones in our pelvic. The biggest bone of our pelvic is known as the ilium, and the smallest bone in our pelvic here is known as ischium. In the center, you will have a pubic bone. In the center, you will have a pubic bone. There are many different bones like crest. We have acetabulum. So there are also different bones in our pelvic. These names of just to know, ilium is and biggest bone of our hip, that is on our buttocks, and ischium is what the smaller bones in our pelvic. And at the center of these two, we have the pubic bone. But the scientific texts count these pelvic bones only two. So we have the only two pelvic bones majorly. They do not consider all ilium, ischium, and they don't count. So they just count the pelvic bones like two. To these pelvic bones, now we have the bones of our legs connected. Before I talk about the bones of our legs, let me tell you all, it is very much important. Please note it down if you are carrying a paper and a pen, the rest of the new people here, that pelvic is the most important part, the first important part in our whole body is in terms of yoga practice, in terms of asana practice, in terms of pranayama practice, in terms of meditation practice, in terms of any cleansing technique. Why? I am saying before back and spine, even if we always say as a yoga professional teacher in our life that try to keep your back and spine straight, try to keep your spine erect, but we should always make sure that if our pelvic hips are not square, if our arrangement of the pelvic, it's up and down, like you can see in this figure. This is not a right appropriate hip, bones are not square. Then the spine also gets not in alignment. So to make sure the proper alignment of the spine, we should adjust or align the pelvic bones first. In any posture, we consider that our hips are not square. And if we are focusing directly on the spine, trying to keep it straight, even if we practice for 20, 30, 40 years, then also we will not be able to keep our spine straight if our pelvic hip bones are not or focused, or our focus is not on our hip bones or pelvic joints. So, clear these things. This is all connected. Until here, if you have any questions, please ask me. Then you will have here the ball and the socket joint. You will find it here. And then you will have the bone in your leg. This is the bone in your leg. Which is this bone, the biggest bone, in longest bone in our leg? This bone is known as femur. Okay. This bone is known as femur. Now, to this femur, you have the next kneecap. This kneecap is known as patella. This kneecap is known as patella bone. Similarly, like our arm, this is your lower leg, and in your lower leg section, the bone which is shaded or the bone which is towards the midline, that is our radius bone. Which one? This is our, like our arm, this is our tibia. I'm sorry, I was considering about the arm. So like our arm, forearm here, the radius bone. Similarly here in our leg, lower leg, we have the bone tibia. See, like our arm, the radius, which carries the weight of the body when you practice yoga or the asana arm balancing. But even when we will stand, even in the samasthiti, like to make sure the square, the hips are square. The samasthiti, that means the base position, is the most difficult asana in the yoga. Even if you think the arm balancing, headstand, different postures are the difficult one. But even standing straight where the hips are square, the belly is tucked in and the spine is neutral position, it is even the toughest thing in the practice of yoga to stand in samasthiti. So in samasthiti, even the weight of our whole body, 60% of the weight is carried by the tibia. More than 60% of the body weight is carried alone by our tibia, the bone of our shin, that means towards our big toe side. Okay, Naringa?
Yeah, all good.
Yeah. Then the bone which is at the lateral side means towards the outside, like our ulna bone in our arm, similarly the lateral side of our calf at the outside, that bone is known as fibula. That bone is known as fibula. So we have the tibia towards the big toe side and fibula towards the lateral side. Tibia is towards the midline. And the bones in our ankles are known as tarsals. So these are the bones in our ankles and the heels, which are known as tarsals. Like the bones in our wrists are known as carpals, similarly the bones in our ankles are known as tarsals. So we have different types of bones, like 7 bones in one ankle. So these 7 bones are like talus bone, we have calcaneus bone, navicular bone, cuneiformis bone, like this many kinds of bones we have with the cuboid. So these group of bones, which are 7, makes our ankle bones in our leg. Like we have carpals in the wrist. So total number of the tarsals will be 14. Total number of the tibia will be?
2.
Fibula?
2.
Kneecap patella?
2.
Femur?
2.
Now, what are remaining? The bones in our tooth. Same, like the phalanges. And metatarsals also are remaining. So how many metatarsals here as well? 2, 3, 4, and 5. Metatarsal means the bones which connect our ankle to our toes. So these are 5 metatarsals. in each foot, in each ankle 7 tarsals, so total 14. Here 10 metatarsals I will denote, and in our toe you will see the same number of phalanges like you see in our fingers. So 3 phalanges in each toe and 2 phalanges in each finger. These are the 7 tarsals. Here, these are the metatarsals. And these black dots are the phalanges. That means they are 14 phalanges in one foot. Similarly, we have 28 phalanges in both the toes. Okay. Clear now?
Yeah.
Can you tell me now how many bones we have seen here? Yes. In our leg, can you tell me? 2 femur plus 2 kneecap plus 2 fibula plus 2 tibia. Here, 8. 8 plus 14 tarsals. How many? 22 plus 10 metatarsals. 32 plus 28 phalanges.
46.
32 plus 28 phalanges.
28.
60. The same number of bones are there in our leg. And the same number of bones are there in our arm. So we have 60 bones in our upper extremity, that is our upper limb, and 60 bones in our leg. So how many are there total? 120 together in our arms and legs. But how many bones are there in our appendicular skeletal system? 126. So where are these 6 bones? These 6 bones are our pelvic girdle and our pectoral girdle. Okay, so in our pectoral girdle, we have 4 bones. That means 2 clavicle and 2 shoulder blade. And in our pelvic, these are the 2 main important bones, hip bones. So these pectoral and pelvic girdles together make 6 bones, where upper limb and lower limb make 120 bones. So the total number of the bones in appendicular skeletal system here are 126. Yesterday we have seen axial skeletal system, where the total number of bones were 8080. Now you can tell me how many number of bones we have seen together. 206, which are nothing but all the bones in our whole body. We have understood the concept, even if we don't have any skeletal. All on the whiteboard, we have seen and cleared the concept. If it is cleared, let me know. If you have any questions, please do ask.
So, just for the pelvic girdle, so yes. Pelvic girdle is, one is ilium, one is ischium, right?
Yeah, and we have acetabulum, we have iliac crest, we have ischium crest, we have pubic bones, but there are like fused bones. So these pelvic bones are fused. Ilium, ischium, pubic. Yes. And?
So all in pelvic girdle, how many bones do we have?
We have we count it as 2 only. These are fused bones. These are not separate from the pelvic. Like we have femur, 2 separate separation. These are fused bones. So they count one single pelvic on each side. So 2 bones.
Yeah.
Yep. So they are fused together. Yeah. So they count it 1. two bones in the pelvis to remember. Your right buttock and left buttock, the right hip and the left hip. Important. The biggest bone, just I am writing here, is ilium. The smallest bone at the bottom, ischium. The center bone, just to know, as a 300-hour student, is the pubic bone. Okay?
Yeah.
We have a new student now, and Namaste, Monica. Am I audible?
Namaste.
Are you from India?
No, Australia.
Okay, you're from Australia. Are you also for the 200 hours or 300 hours course?
I think it's the 200 hour.
Yours, okay. So this session, what we have completed now, actually it was late. We have just finished the session, was for 300 hours. And the session, which is in the morning, according to 8:30 Indian time, is for 200 hours. I would also like to tell you. Even if you will join here, no problem, but make sure your syllabus of 200 hours for anatomy and physiology is different a bit than the syllabus of 300 hours.
Okay, all right.
Just
Thank you.
Anything else, people, you want to ask about today?
No, all clear.
Okay, all good. Thank you. The rest of the people are new. Yes, Akhileshi?
Ashubham ji, may I ask you something?
Yes, please.
Acha, we got on WhatsApp, a PDF of Ashtanga Hridaya Sutra Sthan.
Okay.
This is also for the exams as well. Is it for Ayurveda? Because I've been lost.
I am anatomy teacher, Akhilesh ji. And so there are different teachers for Ashtanga, for Ayurveda. And about the exams, about the videos, about the recordings, these answers are given by the management. So even teachers don't know about is for the exam.
I can answer you the question. Yes, that material is for Ayurveda.
Okay, and for exams as well as a book, no?
Well, to be honest, in the lessons, it's a little like what we're studying now. It's a little bit more different than what is covered in the material there. So just watch the previous lessons recorded.
And about the exam, he's asking about the exam, Naringa. So I don't think you will know about the exam.
Okay.
No. They just said that the exam will be after 1 month. So, but this is all I know.
Okay. So Ashubham ji, aap bas anatomy class ke liye hai na?
Yes, for you, I am here for anatomy class with the Himalayan Yoga Studio.
Okay, and all these that you have written on now are all included on the book?
On the whiteboard, yes?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, great.
Don't worry about the anatomy exams at all.
I'm very worried because I'm so anxious about anatomy.
No, don't worry at all about this. It will be very easy.
Thank you so much.
Yep. We will end class. Yes, just by chanting one om chant. I take, inhale. Thank you so much, people. Have a good day ahead and see you tomorrow.
Thank you.
Namaste.
Thank you.
Thank you, G. Thank you.